Yesterday, 29-year-old Alexandria Marinos told journalists at Nupu's Women League that she was arrested on allegations of supporting and playing National Unity Platform leader Robert Kyagulanyi's music. She mentioned that during her incarceration, she was tortured by CMI officials while Awaneria Sengoba sexually assaulted her.
They caned me while pouring some liquid, which I didn't recognize what it was, on me. They caned me because I was still handcuffed, because they tied me. My hands were up. I was on top of their chair. They caned me. They did all the bad stuffs on me.
UPDF spokesperson Brigadier Felix Kulaiji today dismissed the allegations as baseless.
Where she got the injuries, we don't know. All right? If at all she had them anyway. Because I've also learned that Ugandans have become very industrious. You can paint somebody like one who has had injuries. So I do not know, and our investigations are going on to establish if at all she's indeed injured and who injured her. But my job is to clear the air that she was never anywhere in the CMI detention.
Presenting phone printouts said to be intelligence information, Kulaiji said that data indicates that Marinos was actively making several phone calls on the day she claims she was arrested and detained. The army also presented two people, including one Hassan Sengoba and Sergeant Ali Hassan Matovu, who Marinos accused of personally participating in the torture and alleged rape.
These two were nowhere near her on that day. One, two. The days she alleges to have been kidnapped, she was communicating on phone. So how can you be a kidnapped victim and you're talking to friends? Of course, you're aware that we have access. We can access any telephone conversation. You're aware? Yes. So we have the telephone that she talked with on that very day. And I'm going to give you these details. Three, she has never been anywhere. Anywhere. In a UPDF detention, leave alone CMI. Now, as to why she alleged what the things she alleged, we can only speculate.
The UPDF spokesperson said Matovu only interfaced with Alexandria Marinos in 2020 as part of investigations about Marinos' ex-husband, who was a local defense unit personnel but had deserted. In his testimony, Elias Sengova said he is a UPDF informer who, besides being a neighbor to Alexandria Marinos, had previously worked closely with her.
We've been friends with Alexandria, okay? Not so long and not so short. Actually, Alexandria could call me. I would also call Alexandria, okay? That is some time back. We even met somewhere, I remember late last year. We even had something to drink together. I and Alexander, actually not only two. I was with somebody, we are three.
He is threatening to sue Alexandria over the allegations.
Let me be very clear. I would wish, if all investigations are complete, okay, I would also wish to open up against her of tarnishing my name. Because one, I'm a parent, okay? Secondly, I have in-laws. Thirdly, I have a name. Fourth, I have a legacy. Okay? So why would really somebody come up and concoct such allegations?
Me, as a spokesperson of UPDF, I would wish her to answer these allegations she made against us. We have fought hard to build this image of the UPDF. Now, for somebody, for reasons we are yet to establish, goes on air to soil our image for the sake of some unknown reasons, it's not fair.